Hi, my name is Marina Petri and I'm a nuclear physicist at the University of York. While we know a lot about atomic nuclei that exist here on Earth, there are many open questions regarding exotic nuclei and their properties. Exotic nuclei live for a tiny fraction of a second. And although they do not exist on Earth, they play an important role in the cosmos. In order to study them, we create them in the laboratory and we collide them at high speed with single protons. You can think of this as a bit like a game of pool. When we bash them together, we can knock out one of the protons from inside the nucleus. From the results of the collision, we can work out how the nucleus is put together. In particular, if we measure where the two protons end up, we can learn more about the structure inside these exotic nuclei. To do that, we build a proton tracker.
To build a tracker for fast proton, we face many challenges. To work out what direction a proton is going, we need to detect the proton at least twice. We can then draw a line to show the proton's path. The solution is simple. We use two or more layers of detectors. Of course, that makes the detector bigger and more expensive. Then we don't want the detectors to change the direction of the protons as they pass through. So we have to make them as thin as possible. We use layers of silicon less than a fraction of a millimeter. And because protons are small, really small, we want the detector to be as precise as possible. We divide the detector in really thin strips on both sides of the silicon layer. That means we end up with a lot of strips that we have to monitor, more than 60,000. That's a lot of electronics. And finally, we want to detect the protons wherever they end up. So we want to maximize the detector's area around the collision.
The mechanical assembly and electronics design were the biggest challenges in building this new detector. The detector is quite large, but we can only produce silicon sensors of a certain size. So we had to bond multiple sensors together, connecting them with huge numbers of these tiny wires. Then, with so many strips, we couldn't use traditional electronics to monitor all of that information. Instead, we developed our own systems. These little chips, known as ASICs, or application-specific integrated circuits. All the electronics we need, which used to be the size of a fridge with great big cables coming out, now fit onto these tiny chips just a centimeter across, connected right to the detector strips by thin wires.
Building a new detector like this has loads of difficult challenges. The best way to tackle them is to bring together experts in lots of different areas. In physics simulations, to check feasibility and optimize the design before investing lots of money in the construction. In mechanical design and engineering to construct the real device, in electronics and microelectronics to read out the response of the detector, in software engineering to control the electronics, in project management to keep everything moving along, on track and within budget, and highly skilled technicians to put the whole thing together. So whether you're a physicist, an electronics or software engineer, a project manager or a technician, there's a role for you in high-tech, state-of-the-art, fundamental and applied research, like we are doing here at Daresbury Lab.